Welcome, guys. Welcome again to another Not In Depth. Thank you guys for watching my videos. Thank you guys. What do we got here? So today I'm going to make a video. It's going to be based about how to send emails. So when you have clients, they're trying to reach out to you. They want to reach out to you, and they want to send you a message. They can do that. They can send a message through the contact form, and it's going to go directly into your email. So, and that way you don't miss any messages, any clients. So that way you can, get some work. So if you watch the video all the way to the end, I will show you where you can actually get the code and everything. All right. So the first thing you guys are going to need to do is you guys going to have to create, an account here with email.js. This one here gives you 200 emails pretty much every day. So, and their email.js is free. Don't have to pay anything. I think 200 emails daily, I think is plenty. And, you know, and now if you start growing and you get a lot of clients, yeah, that's a different story. You probably gonna need more than that, but it's free to start. It's 200 emails. So, and that goes, it connects directly into my email. So they give you a nice documentation here. Like, you can actually go here to email.js. You can actually go, it says here, connecting email service, and it can actually, it tells you how to do it. Let me see. It gives you creating an email template. You can actually, you know, it tells you there how to do it. Let's go here. Let's start with the first one here. It says connecting email. Open the email service, which is right here. This is right here. So first thing you want to do is you want to create a service. The one I'm going to be using, I'm using Gmail. Gmail is right here. This is the one service. I haven't tried it with AOL. I haven't tried it with Fastmail, and I haven't tried none of these. But I tried it with a Gmail, and it works pretty good. So what you want to do is you want to create a service, and it's going to give you a service ID. So this service ID, which is right here, so you can actually test it before you can actually connect this. See, it's connected to my regular email right here. So this key here, you can actually change it. And you can actually change it or refresh. You can disconnect it. You can delete the service. But this video here, I'm doing it right now. So I'm doing it right here. This IP right here, you're going to have to create your own. This here, I'm using it for the video. I'm letting you see it. So that way you guys can, can do the same thing. So then once you created your service, you want to need to create an email template, which is right here. You create a template here. Here it says subject. You can, so it says new message from, you know, the name, hello name. This is all of this here. I put down here another one for the subject and the message. And then I put down, you can edit this actually. You can actually edit. You can actually go here where it says co-editor, and you can actually change it. Whatever changes you want to do, you can apply it. It gives you actually the example. And you want to hit apply changes once you do the changes. And here, what you can do with yours, I'm using my email address here. I'm putting the name. And then I'm also here, I'm going to use the default email address, which is this one. So that's that. And then you're going to need, once you create this template, you want to go here to settings. Inside the settings is going to give you a template ID, which you are going to need that. We're going to use JavaScript to connect this. And actually, you can actually test it. So you can actually test it. You can actually put it here. And so I'm gonna put down Martin. The subject is gonna be I'm just gonna put down websites like that. I'm gonna put down messages. This message is for testing, reply to my email. So then I'm gonna hit send email, and it's gonna give you, it might give you an error code. See, right now it's not working because it's not working. Why is it not working? Email testing. Da, 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 da. Oh, I see why it's not working. Okay. So the reason why it's not working is because I have to go to the email service here. And this one here, I'm going to have to create a new one. So if you go here, because I create a new service, let me go ahead and disconnect this. Let me go ahead and let's go ahead and delete this one. So I'm going to go ahead and delete this. Hit delete. Okay. So I'm going to create a new service. I'm going to use my Gmail because you have to see it's going to give you a new key. So I'm going to hit connect. So it's going to ask me to connect. Continue. You have to authorize this. Email, JS. Okay, so I'm going to hit continue. So now create service. So it's going to create the service. See, it's right there. So now let me go back again to email templates. And I'm going to go here. I'm going to go ahead and test it. And then I'm going to do it again. Let me do messages. Let me do the subject. It's going to put down websites. And I put down the messages. This is a message for testing. And I put down reply back. And now let's go ahead and just hit, let's hit send test email. And see, you have the 200 now. So, so make sure that your key is populated, which is over here on the email service. Make sure that key is this right here, the service ID. Make sure it's populated. So that's how you test it. Now that you know it is working, this is the back end. So then you can actually go to the history. See, it gives you the history. If it's not working, it's going to give you all of that. So now if you get stuck, you can always go to the documentation, which is right here. You can actually check on that. All right, so let's go back. So now we know it's working. So now we can actually, write the code. So the first thing you want to do in your contact form, you are going to need a key, which is your public key, which is that is going to be in right here. And you can change it. So I am, once I'm done with the video, I will change it for security purpose. So but you will get it right here. This is the key. You can refresh it and then I will change it to a new key. So once you have that, you're going to need that key and you can actually, you're going to have to go back to here, to your website. So here you're going to have to bring this, you're going to have to bring the script, this CDN, and you're going to have to put it on the bottom. And see, I have it right here. This is script email.js. And here you're going to have to imprint the public key, which is right here. And then you also want to bring in your, so I'm using, I created a file. It's called mail.js, which is right here. Inside here, what I did is I created a variable BTN for the button. I created one for the contact form, and then I added an event listener and I hit submit. And also I added some parameters here, one for the name, one for the email, one for the subject, one for the message. And here what I did is I changed the value to sending when it's, when it actually sends the messages. And then I created another variable for the service ID, one for the template. And then inside the email.js, I use the function send, and I use the three parameters here: service ID, template ID, and parameters. So then once I got that, then I once the message goes through, I clear the form, which is right here, and then I notify the whoever sending messages that says that is I'm going to alert says message has been sent. So then I am going to, change the value to send email. And if there's any error codes here, this will print out inside on the actual screen. So here in the bottom, I was actually using it for testing. So you can do another way too. You can actually create a function and you can actually call this function inside the contact form, which is right here. You can actually call that in over here. You can create a function onClick. You can do onClick event, and when every time you click. So then here, this is the contact form. This is my whole entire contact form. Here, don't work together. That's the place. Right here. So the form is right here, and I give it an ID, a contact form. Let me go ahead and get this screen a little bigger. Oh, too much. So let me go ahead and do this. So again, guys, right here. So here it is, so that you guys can see much better. So this is the contact form. This is I added the event listener. This is the parameters. So all of this here, that's the JavaScript. So you guys can use it. And let me go bring it down again. Bring it out to this. No, that's too little. Yeah, there it is. So all of that. So you guys can use it, do the same thing, and I'm pretty sure it works. So mine works. So I don't have to touch it up. So mine right here, I'm going to have to update it. But yeah, so whenever you send a message, you can fill it up. And if you haven't watched the, if you haven't watched the previous video, the previous video, I actually, I tested it and it works. So you guys can do the same thing. Let me see, make sure I'm not forgetting anything. Let me see what else. Oh, so let me go ahead and close this website here. So here is actually the code. If you want to go ahead and modify the code, whatever you guys want to do, this is my contact HTML here. So here you guys can copy it and you guys can modify whatever you want, whatever you guys want to do with it. So here is the script. Here is the CDN. This is the email JS to initialize. And make sure, don't forget to put your public key right here. And then I also have the JavaScript for you guys here. So here, all you guys do is just copy and paste it. But if you guys want me to explain to you how I did this, you guys are welcome to send me a message on the bottom of the video. But I'll go ahead and link this to the video so you guys can use it for yours and start, you know, customers can start messaging you, sending you messages, and this thing will actually go directly to your email. So, all right, guys. So hopefully you found this video useful for you guys, and make sure, don't forget to subscribe. Make sure you share the video. Make sure you leave your comments on the bottom of the video, and stay tuned for more videos. Keep coding, keep moving forward, and I'll see you on the next video, guys. Stay tuned for more. Peace and keep coding. See you guys in the next one.